Get ready to match the stars. Nipsey Russell, Brett Somers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Beverly Garland, Richard Dawson, and Betty White as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 73. And now here's the host of Match Game 73, Gene Rayburn.
Hello there. Thank you, Johnny Olson. How do you do? Fine. Oh, yes, we're both wearing our tweeds.
Yes.
It's very 20s, you know.
Yes, and 30s.
Well,
and 40s and 30s.
Is everyone prepared?
No. For what?
For whatever is going to go on
what
here.
What sort of question is that?
I'm prepared to sleep over.
What do you say we all say so. Hello to our two players here, Jerry Brownell and Sharon Moser.
All right.
Hello there.
Sharon
is our current champ. She's won $450, two games under her belt, and she's doing pretty well here.
Yes.
You happy about that?
Yes, very good.
Okay.
Pleased.
She's being challenged by Jerry. We started the game last time out, finished his end of round one, in which he zipped out, I guess.
Right.
And we're going to go to your question here in a moment or so. You ready? Okay. First, these messages, and then on with the game. Okay, here we go on with the completion of round one. Sharon, this is for you, and everybody plays. Harvey said, "Hello, doctor. Now, don't laugh, but I got my blank stuck in a soda bottle."
I told you not to laugh, doctor.
No, I couldn't have said that.
Charles is ready, and everybody down here is just about ready.
It's just about finished.
Now, Brett, would you make up your mind, please? And okay. All set. So, Sharon, we
no,
come
I
to
can't.
You.
No, I can't. Okay.
You're changing your mind.
Dr. Fentworth.
I couldn't. I got sweaty
okay.
palms.
All right. Sharon, Harvey said, "Hello, doctor. Now, don't laugh, but I got my blank stuck in a soda bottle." What do you say to that, Sharon?
I say tongue.
Tongue?
What's he saying?
That's an interesting answer. I wonder how he was able to talk to the... Well, I don't care. Nipsey, it's your problem, not mine. What do you say?
I was wondering how she could talk to the doctor. And Brett threw me, too. Of course, Brett works for a doctor. She's not a nurse. She just stands in front of the office and makes people sick.
My finger. He said finger. Tongue is the answer. Come now, Brett. It's all in the spirit of fun.
I was only joking.
We love you, dear.
Uh-huh.
Let me see your
serious.
Answer.
It's my last nickel of the NAACP.
Answer, darling. The answer.
Show and tell time.
Oh, is it my turn?
Yeah.
Oh, well, never mind. I'll write letters about what I actually said. Finger.
Finger. All right. Tongue is what she said, Charles.
There are three major answers. No, and I'm sorry. A tongue is excellent. Finger is also popular.
Okay. All right. Have you got one of the popular answers,
yes,
Beverly?
I've got a very popular answer. Tongue.
Okay, that matches, Sharon. How about you, sir?
He said, "Doctor, I have my tongue in the bottle." And the doctor said, "So do I. I wonder what we can do about it."
Okay, now you're going there.
It's just, don't laugh.
Finger.
Finger, okay. So you scored twice with that. So at the end of round one, it's 2-0 favor the champ. We go to round two. And you, sir, make a selection.
Let's try B.
He wants B. Now, Jerry didn't match anybody out the first time around, so that means everybody plays.
Okay.
Marvin has been out of the Army for 10 years, but every morning he still blanks. I say Marvin has been out of the Army for 10 years.
Army, he said.
Army.
Oh, yes, oh, I get it.
But every morning he still blanks. There now, see? Army for 10 years, but every morning he's still...
I want to change.
All right, you've got time because Nipsey hasn't thought of him yet. Ready down here. All right, Jerry. Marvin has been out of the Army for 10 years, but every morning he still...
Salutes.
salutes.
I think I'd say that too.
What do you say, Nipsey?
I was gonna say every morning he still rises, but then I said salutes.
Salutes is a match, okay. Brett?
I'm not speaking to Nipsey.
Why not?
I'll tell you later. He still salutes.
Salutes. All right, you got two there, Charles.
Well, see, this is so unanimous. A show like this is so provocative in its psychological depth. It is because he married Mona, who's rather a truck driver type wife, so he's still and will always, until Marvin dies, salute.
Salute. Okay, Beverly.
What can I tell you? He salutes.
He salutes. Boy, you're up to four, Jerry. And Richard.
Well, I happen to know that he salutes his wife and makes his own bed. I believe she would wish it to be vice versa, but makes his bed.
He still makes his bed.
Okay. Just the deep thinkers.
I'm laughing, yeah. Okay, Betty.
Well, you see, being older than all this group put together, I've done a lot of war work in my time, and from what I
bet you have, honey.
Grabs his sock.
Haven't you heard that?
Yeah.
Get up, that's right.
I heard that someplace. Okay, Jerry, you're up to four. 4-2 is the score at this point, middle of round two. Now, you must score twice to stay in the game. Three will win the game. Here we go. Everybody plays except Beverly and Richard. Harry said, "That girl must be a Playboy bunny. Just look at her blank." That girl must be a Playboy bunny. Just look at her blank.
I'm ready, Gene.
I bet you are. Are you Charles?
That's Charles.
Just look at her. Betty's ready? Now we're all set. So Sharon, Harry said that girl must be a Playboy bunny. Just look at her...
tail.
At her tail. Okay. Nipsey, what do you say? She says tail.
I was over to the Playboy Club dressed as a carrot. Her tail.
Tail is there. Need one more to tie. Bet and Brett.
Without exception, those are two of the worst answers I have heard since I've been doing the show.
But they match.
But, you know, I never imagine my taste in perception.
So I tie one more, you win the game. Charles.
The ears are what I was, well...
ears.
But we
okay,
have a whole other
now we skip Beverly and Richard and go over to Betty. One tail wins the game.
I'd like to chip in a couple of dollars.
Just don't mess with me, Cottontail.
Does that win the game? That wins the game. Congratulations. We congratulate you, and you stand by for a moment or so here while we say goodbye to Jerry. It's been a pleasure meeting you, Jerry. We've got a gift for you, together with our thanks for being on Match Game 73.
Thank you.
Jerry Brownell. Now we'll get back to this lady, but first we've got this message for you. Here we go with a super match where this lady can win over $5,000. Are you ready, Sharon?
I'm ready.
All right, you know how it goes. We polled a recent studio audience. We got the best response to this. Knock blank. The answer they gave most often is worth $500 if you can match it. Second most frequent response, $250. And the third, $100. Which celebrities would you like a little help from?
Nipsey.
What do you say, Nipsey? Knock.
For Muhammad Ali, I say knockout.
Knockout. There's one answer.
Betty, knock on wood.
Knock on wood is another one.
Beverly.
I was hoping that wouldn't happen.
What do you say? Have you got one, Beverly?
Sure, I've got one. Knock, knock.
Knock, knock. Okay. So you got knockout, knock on wood, and knock knock. You may choose one of those as the answer, or give us one of your own if you'd like. What would you like to do?
Knockout.
Knockout. Okay, pow. Knockout is Nipsey's answer, and that's the one we're looking for. Let's find out if it's up there first. May we see the $100 response. Knock on wood is there. It's the one that Betty gave you. All right, still looking for knockout. Here is the $250 response. Knockout is there.
Not me.
All right.
Not me.
You got the $250 and it's all yours just for the heck of it. What do you think is under the $500? Do you know?
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
You think so?
Knock me.
What do you think is there? Knock out?
Who's there? Knock.
Here is the $500 response.
Knock,
knock. Knock, knock. He is there. Yes, indeed, Beverly, you were right all along. Okay, Sharon, you've got the $250. That means you're going to be playing for 10 times that amount now, or $2,500. To collect that amount, you got to match one celebrity. Exact match. Which one will it be?
Soul Brother Nipsey.
I is elected.
Right.
If I was elected, there'll
She's
be a biscuit
me,
tree on get... every corner and molasses flowing in the gutter.
Here's the $2,500 question. Cat blank.
What?
C-A-T blank.
Cat.
Cat okay. blank or cat blank.
Do I have to write it down? Better be.
Ready?
Yes.
All right, you want to shove it all the way in?
Yes.
So no. There it is. That's it. Okay. Now, Sharon, give us your response to this. How do you fill in the blank?
Cat guts.
Cat gut, you say?
Cat gut. Gut.
Okay.
That's what I said.
That's her answer. All right, for $2,500, Nipsey, may we see yours? Catnap is his answer. Okay, you didn't win the $2,500, but you're up to $800 already, Sharon.
You're gonna
meet another player. Here comes Kathy Metcalf.
Hi, Kathy.
Kathy, you know Sharon. And would you tell us a little bit about yourself, if you please,
okay.
ma'am?
I'm single, I live in Ventura, and I'm a teacher's aide at an elementary school in Ventura.
And what kind of teaching do you do?
I just help small groups of kids.
I see. Okay, you know how to play this game.
Sure do.
All right, I'll push a button, we'll get underway. We ask you as a challenger to make a selection. Would you do that?
I'll try B.
She wants B, we've got a new game, everybody plays. This is it. Her mother said, Fatima, Fatima, if you're going for a ride on Aladdin's flying carpet, you better take along a blank.
What?
I see you're pretty thrilled with this question. Fatima, if you're going for a ride on Aladdin's flying carpet, you better take along a blank. This is another
talking
to Fatima.
I don't believe in violence, but if I could find the person who wrote that question... There'd be a lot of ugliness in the world.
But I'm ready.
You are ready, okay? We're all ready down here.
Okay, we're ready. We're not very ready, but
not
we're
very.
Ready.
Kathy, how do you respond to this? Her mother said, Fatima, if you're going for a ride on Aladdin's flying carpet, you better take along a...
Pillow.
A pillow?
A pillow.
A pillow, she says. That's a logical answer. What do you say, Nipsey?
Well, I thought, what did Aladdin have? And I was first going to say his genie, but he's flying in the dark, so take along Aladdin's lamp.
A lamp. Okay, so, all right, that's his answer. Brett,
right,
what's yours?
And I'll stick with it, because I'm stuck with it.
Well, Fat Emma. Say it.
Fatima.
We say
that's
Fatima.
That's the same as Fat. Oh, lap robe.
A lap robe. Okay. All right,
Charles. Anything
can...
worse than the question?
Charles,
may
we see yours?
No, it was no mumbling when he said lamp.
You don't dare.
When the cameras photograph this, does it look like I'm with the other children? Aladdin happens to be a mess. The lamp fuel goes all over. He eats peanuts and he smokes and he gets ashes. She had to bring a vacuum if there's going to be a vacuum cleaner.
That one.
I'll take this.
Okay,
oh,
Beverly.
Dear, yes, let there be light. Take your lamp.
Take along a lamp so you can see what's going
That's
on.
Right.
Pillow is the answer that she is looking for. Richard, what have you got for her?
I've got 2 weekends in Palm Springs. And a sandwich to go. No, if you want a very dangerous on a flying carpet.
Right.
Guy makes a move, you go over the edge. What would you need? All together. A parachute.
Right.
Get out.
Exactly.
Get out.
Betty?
Put your shoes on and leave, Dickie.
Thank you.
A lamp.
Lamp.
And I'm not going to even comment.
So, Kathy, there's no score there. Sharon, we'll get to yours. But first, we've got a message, and this is it. Shall we carry on?
Okay. We go to the second half of round one. Sharon, this is for you.
Okay.
Everyone participates, folks?
We all play.
Barbara lost her blank in the jungle. Barbara lost her blank in the jungle.
Barbara lost her blank.
Huh. Would you like to read it?
That's what it says. Barbara lost her blank in the jungle.
Okay. You believe me, don't you, Beverly?
No.
Barbara lost her blank in the jungle.
That's you know.
I think that's going to be my next song title.
I have a pigeon in my blank.
Okay,
Nipsey. Nipsey's very pokey this week. Have you noticed that?
He has a pygmy in his poke.
Sharon,
no, that's
Barbara lost her blank in the jungle. What say you to that?
Virginity.
I see your husband's applauding.
He's just okay. Hoping to get lucky.
Her answer is virginity.
We now, heard it.
Oh, you did.
You know what the answer? What's the question?
What do you say, Nipsey? What's yours?
She lost it on a safari.
She lost her safari in a jungle. I see. Okay, Brett.
They started off with a lot of them.
It's more reasonable that she would lose her safari.
Not necessarily. It's all according to who you are. She lost her innocence in the jungle, which is more or less
that's
the
right.
same.
That's true. All right, there's one match, Sharon. Okay, Charles.
I'd like to be in the rooming house where you were 17 years old and you came home to your mother and you said you lost your innocence.
I never told my mother things like that.
She my mother
was a nice woman.
She met a wild tribe and they changed her name from Barbara to Bubbles and she lost her virginity.
Okay, that's two for you. What do you say, Beverly?
Well, she would have lost her virginity, but she didn't have the courage.
Lost her courage. Okay, Richard.
It's known as monkey business. Virginity.
Okay. Betty?
She merely lost her way.
That's
now
it.
Make of that what you will.
Okay. Straight answer. Do not interpret that in any other way. So it's 3-0 at this moment. And we go to round two, right? Here we go with round two, Kathy.
I'll try A this time.
Kathy wants A, and everybody plays. The Internal Revenue agent said to Frank, I don't care if you call it entertainment or not, you can't deduct the cost of a blank. The Internal Revenue agent said to Frank, I don't care if you call it entertainment or not, you can't deduct the cost of a blank. Oh, you're finished. Quick thinker.
Yes. I've always been a quick thinker and a slow doer.
All ready. Now they're all ready. So, Kathy, we come to you. The Internal Revenue agent said to Frank, I don't care if you call it entertainment or not, you can't deduct the cost of a...
bed.
A what?
A bed.
A bed?
Yeah.
A B-E-D bed. I'll drink to that. Okay.
That's a great answer. Wonderful.
Yes. Bed is her answer, and it's up to our judges to interpret your answers and see what's going to have a match here. Or not, Nipsey.
We were upset. My little nephew swallowed a dime.
Yes.
We took him to the Internal Revenue. Do you know they made him cough it up? Massage.
A massage. Okay, no match there. Brett.
You know they used to be before there were zippers?
Yeah.
There used to be things, and you had to go like
right,
that.
Right.
And you had to get them all buttoned
hurry
up. And
up,
they called them hookers.
Okay, Charles. Right, I got it. Charles.
Blue movie. Kind of a dull answer, and it just made a whole other program.
All right, you got a match here. Beverly.
Girlfriend.
Girlfriend and
sorry.
Bed does not match. So Sharon wins again. Congratulations. There's another 100 for you. And Kathy, we're going to have to say goodbye to you. We thank you for being with us here on Match Game 73. Kathy Metcalf, bye. Oh. We'll join you and Sharon here right after this. You were absolutely terrific. Join us next time when we'll have this galaxy of stars.
Jack Cassidy, Brett Somers, Charles Nelson Reilly, June Lockhart, Richard Dawson, and Loretta Swit.
Team Raven for Match Game 73. Bye.
Today's consolation prizes are from Montgomery Ward's Big Ball Catalog. The Powercraft Hobby Rotary Toolkit makes small repair jobs even smaller from the Montgomery Ward Catalog. And Papermate Executive Pen and Pencil Set features the Papermate PowerPoint pen that pumps ink into the point so it writes at any angle. And an assortment of Trouble aftershave and cologne gift sets. Trouble has a scratchy sit spot on the outside so you can smell what's inside. And a supply of Swiss Miss Cocoa. Delicious toffee, mocha, cinnamon, malt, and chocolate flavored instant mixes. Just add hot water. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 73. A Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. Get ready to match the stars. Nipsey Russell, Brett Somers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Beverly Garland, Richard Dawson, and Betty White as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 73. And now here's the host of Match Game 73, Gene Rayburn.
Hello there. Thank you, Johnny Olson.
How do you do?
Fine. Oh, yes, we're both wearing our tweeds.
Yes.
It's very 20s, you know.
Yes, and 30s.
Well, and 40s. Really.
Is everyone prepared?
No. For what?
For whatever is going to go on here.
What sort of question is that?
I'm prepared to sleep over.
What do you say we all say hello to our two players here, Jerry Brownell and Sharon Moser?
All right.
Hello there.
Hi.
Sharon is our current champ. She's won $450, two games under her belt, and she's doing pretty well here.
Yes.
You happy about that?
Yes, very good.
Okay.
Pleased.
She's being challenged by Jerry. We started the game last time out, finished his end of round one, in which he zipped out, I guess.
Right.
And we're going to go to your question here in a moment or so. You ready? Okay. First, these messages, and then on with the game. Okay, here we go on with the...
Finger.
All right, tongue is what she said, Charles.
There are three major answers. No, and I'm sorry, a tongue is excellent. Finger is also popular.
Okay, all right. Have you got one of the popular answers,
Yes,
Beverly?
I've got a very popular answer. Tongue.
Okay, that matches, Sharon. How about you, sir?
He said, Doctor, I have my tongue in the bottle. And the doctor said, so do I. I wonder what we can do about it.
Okay, now you're going there.
Don't blow off.
Finger.
Okay. So you scored twice with that. So at the end of round one, it's 2-0 in favor of the champ. We go to round two. And you, sir, make a selection.
Let's try B.
He wants B. Now, Jerry didn't match anybody out the first time around, so that means everybody plays.
Okay.
Marvin has been out of the Army for 10 years, but every morning, he still blanks. I say Marvin has been out of the Army for 10 years.
Army, he said.
Army.
Oh, yes, oh, I get it.
But every morning, he still blanks. There now, see?
Army for 10 years, but every morning he's still...
I want to change.
All right, you've got time, because Nipsey hasn't thought of him yet. Ready down here. All right, Jerry. Marvin has been out of the Army for 10 years, but every morning he's still...
Salutes.
Salutes. I think I'd say that, too. What do you say, Nipsey?
I was going to say every morning he still rises, but then I said salutes.
Salutes is a match. Okay. Betty's ready? Now we're all set. So, Sharon, Harry said that girl must be a Playboy bunny. Just look at her...
tail.
At her tail. Okay. Nipsey, what do you say? She says tail.
I was over to the Playboy Club dressed as a carrot. Her tail.
Tail is there. Need one more to tie. Brett.
Without exception, those are two of the worst answers I have heard since I've been doing the show.
But they match.
But, you know, I never match to my taste in perception.
So I tie one more, you win the game. Charles.
The ears are what I was... well.
Ears.
But we
okay,
have a whole other
now we skip Beverly and Richard and go over to Betty. One tail wins the game.
I'd like to chip in a couple of dollars.
Just don't mess with me, Cottontail.
Yeah. Does that win the game? That wins the game. Congratulations. We congratulate you, and you stand by for a moment or so here while we say goodbye to Jerry. It's been a pleasure meeting you, Jerry. We've got a gift for you, together with our thanks for being on Match Game 73.
Thank you.
Jerry Brownell. Now we'll get back to this lady, but first we've got this message for you. Here we go with a super match where this lady can win over $5,000. Are you ready, Sharon?
I'm ready.
All right, you know how it goes. We polled a recent studio audience. We got the best response to this. Knock blank. The answer they gave most often is worth $500. The completion of round one, Sharon, this is for you and everybody plays. Harvey said, "Hello, doctor. Now, don't laugh, but I got my blank stuck in a soda bottle." I told you not to laugh, doctor.
No, I couldn't have said that.
Charles is ready, and everybody down here is just about ready.
It's just about finished.
Now, Brett, would you make up your mind, please? And... okay. All set. So, Sharon, we
no,
come
I
to
can't.
You.
No, I can't. Okay.
You're changing your mind.
Dr. Fentworth.
I couldn't. I got sweaty
okay.
palms.
All right. Sharon, Harvey said, "Hello, doctor. Now, don't laugh, but I got my blank stuck in a soda bottle." What do you say to that, Sharon?
I say tongue.
Tongue?
What's she saying?
That's an interesting answer. I wonder how he was able to talk to the... well, I don't care. Nipsey, it's your problem, not mine. What do you say?
I was wondering how she could talk to the doctor. And Brett threw me, too. Of course, Brett works for a doctor. She's not a nurse. She just stands in front of the office and makes people sick.
Got my finger. He said finger. Tongue is the answer. Come now, Brett, it's all in the spirit of fun.
I was all in joke.
We love you, dear.
Uh-huh.
May we see your
serious.
Answer.
It's my last nickel of the NAACP.
Answer, darling, the answer.
Show and tell time.
Oh, is it my turn?
Yeah.
Oh, well, never mind. I'll write letters about my, what I actually said.
Brett?
I'm not speaking to Nipsey.
Why not?
I'll tell you later. He still salutes.
Salutes. All right, you got two there, Charles.
Well, see, this is so unanimous. A show like this is so provocative in its psychological depth. It is because he married Mona, who's rather a truck driver type wife, so he's still and will always, until Marvin dies, salute.
Salute. Okay, Beverly.
What can I tell you? He salutes.
He salutes. Boy, you're up to four, Jerry. And Richard.
Well, I happen to know that he salutes his wife and makes his own bed. I believe she would wish it to be vice versa, but makes his bed.
He still makes his bed.
Not just the deep thinkers.
All laughing, yes.
Okay, Betty.
Well, you see, being older than all this group put together, I've done a lot of war work in my time, and from what I
bet you have, honey.
Only
that
side.
Grabs his side.
Haven't you heard that?
Yeah.
Get up,
yeah, that's right. I heard that someplace. Okay, Jerry, you're up to four. 4-2 is the score at this point, middle of round two. Now, you must score twice to stay in the game. Three will win the game. Here we go. Everybody plays except Beverly and Richard. Harry said, "That girl must be a Playboy bunny. Just look at her blank." That girl must be a Playboy bunny. Just look at her blank.
I'm ready, Gene.
I bet you are. Are you Charles?
That's Charles.
Just look at her